Welcome back. You're with us on Reporter's Diary. Now, incessant rainfall, the heaviest in fact since 2005, continues to batter Mumbai and parts of western Maharashtra. Several areas are waterlogged in Mumbai, hampering the movement of people. Right now, you'll see on your screens visuals of waterlogging at Wilson College, a 188-year-old college. Heavy rains and gusty winds have also uprooted trees, leading to traffic jams in several parts, including the Western Express Highway, which is an arterial road. Now, local trains have been suspended on the city's Harbour Line and also on the Western Line between Mumbai Central and Churchgate. The Met Department has issued a red alert for the Mumbai metropolitan region and some of the parts of Maharashtra. And air traffic data in July showing a marginal increase compared to July, but the first 3 days in August are offering more hope. Anu Sharma is here with the numbers. Anu, what are you gathering?
Right, so the first 3 days of August, if we compare that with the first 3 days of July, there has been a slight improvement. But before that, let me run you through the numbers of June and July. Now, in June, the domestic airlines carried a total of around 19.8 lakh passengers. A back of the envelope calculation shows us that this number has risen in the month of July, and it is around 20 lakh passengers. So definitely there is some improvement in terms of traffic. And if you look at the departures, then over 21,500 departures took place in June. And if you compare this with the figure of July, then this has risen to around 23,500. So these are the flight departures that the month of July has seen. Now we come to the month of August, which started with festivals like Eid and Rakhi. And if you look at the 3 days, August 1st, 2nd, and third, the domestic departures have risen by 12%, 12% and 9% on month if you compare it with the same days in the month ago period of July. And if you look at the total number of passengers which have been carried by airlines, that have also risen by a whopping 25% on the 1st of August if you compare it with July 1st. And then on July August 2nd and 3rd, this number has risen by on month by 17% and by 14%. Now, we did speak to some travel websites like Yatra.com and Make My Trip and Ease My Trip, etc. So Yatra has told us that there has been a steady uptick in demand, considering that people wanted to travel for essential purposes in the initial months since the travel resumed on May 25th. But then people were still cautious in making the bookings because they were a bit apprehensive about the quarantine rules and the restrictions by different states. But then there was a slight uptick in the traffic, in the bookings that were made around the festival season of Rakhi and Eid. Now, if you look at the comments which had come in from Ease My Trip, then they have said that the maximum bookings that they have seen is for Delhi-Srinagar, followed by Delhi-Patna on the first three days of August. And over 90% of passengers are booking their tickets within 3 days of their travel. So clearly, different trends are emerging, and we'll have to wait and watch out for more data to come from DGCA and other government platforms. For now, back to you.
Right, Anu, many thanks for getting us all those details. On that note, we'll slip into a short break, but coming up on the other side, Prime Minister Narendra Modi lays the foundation stone of the Ram Mandir in Ayodhya, says the Ram Temple will usher in a new era of unity and Vikas. All that and more on the other side.